Have a good day, everyone. I'm Malai Porn Son Pachan from the Graduate School of Science and Technology for Innovation at Yamaguchi University, Japan. Today, I would like to present on the title, the concept of hybrid flexible lecture using H323 protocol of remote conferencing system. This is the agenda. First, I will start with an introduction to the concept of hybrid flexible lecture. Second, problem statement. Third, objective of study. Fourth, methodology. Fifth, results. Sixth, conclusion and future work. I'm briefly to talk about digital transformation in education, focus on how Yamaguchi University adapt to rapid technical change and the impact of global challenges like COVID pandemic on remote learning. First, let's look back at pre-COVID-19 Yamaguchi University was conducted by relaying lecture room on multiple campus via remote lecture system. With the implement and H264 conduct teleconferencing system across campus before the coronavirus outbreak in 2019. However, the onset of COVID-19 brought a swift transition to online class. Tools like Zoom and WebEx were rapidly adapted, making a new era of non-contact education, obvious with initial challenge and confusion. Therefore, this study reports a feasibility test conducted in 2020 when the introduction of online class began of the high-fake format in which online and face-to-face lecture are conducted simultaneously in anticipation of teaching style after the end of corona disaster. Let's dive into technical aspect. What are the H264 codec and what's H323 protocol? The H264 codec, also known as Advanced Video Coding AVC, play a crucial role in compressing video file while maintaining high quality. This makes it ideal for internet streaming and HDTV, ensure clear video conferencing. On the other hand, the H323 protocol governs multimedia communication over non-traditional phone network. It standardizes initiation, management, and termination of real-time multimedia session, enabling smooth interoperability between different network drives and applications. Especially H323 is utilized to connect on-premise conferencing system with online service like WebEx for hybrid learning. Now let's address the challenges in implementing hybrid flexible lecture. First is moving class online quickly during COVID-19. That's the challenge of the online transition. Next, we focus on operational efficiency, emphasizing the importance of cost-effective and efficient management for multi-campus class and conference. Finally, we highlight the efficiency of hybrid model, showing case the hybrid method as technological solution for simultaneous classroom and online teaching. Next is the objective of our study. First, we intend to explore the feasibility test of the hybrid flexible lecture format. Secondly, we endeavor to assess the efficiency of investigating on-premise conferencing system with cloud-based service for hybrid learning. Lastly, we tackle to challenge the of technological infrastructure, student engagement, and quality of education in a high-fake model. Next, the methodology. In this study, conducted feasibility tests, setting up and executing H323 protocol test connection by linking an on-premise conferencing system and WebEx. In this light, let's get into how high-based flexible class work or high-fec class format. First, we have in-person lecture. In this regular way of learning where students are in the classroom, talking and engaging with directly with their lecture. Face-to-face sessions are essential tool emphasizing interactive learning with faculty present. Second, the delivery methods are diverse. We have simultaneous delivery, meaning that the same content is broadcast live to students in the classroom and online, ensuring everyone a consistent learning experience. Thus, our high-fec class lecture is innovative. We offer recorded lecture for simultaneous learning, providing flexibility for those who can't attend in real time. Additionally, we integrate advanced conferencing technology like H323 system and WebEx to live stream lecture directly from the classroom. Moving on the next slide, the H264 Kodak-based teleconferencing system is designed for teleconferencing. It assures a mode in which both parties face each other face to face in equal position. This mode is called meeting mode. In figure 1, show the connecting diagram of device that supports the meeting mode. The connect device consists of two remote video camera, two flat panel about 60 inch, a Kodak and a PC. The dedicated in video camera are connected separately for the video signal, HDMI cable and control via cable and channel signal and zoom are adjusted by remote controller. In figure 2, feasibility test demonstrate a high-fec connect using a conference room with an on-premise conferencing system as a classroom. The instructor online lecture via WebEx is relayed simultaneously to online student connected from the internet and to the on-premise conferencing system in the classroom. Online students view the lecture video and material on their PC, while students in the classroom view the same content projected on a large screen. Both displays convey the same quality of information, with the only distinction being the same of display device. In figure 3 is the system diagram that represents feasibility test of the high-fec method in an actual class. This show the different components of the system and how they are connected to each other. The lecture in this test are delivered by different instructors each time, which means that system must be able to accommodate different teaching style and performance. The diagram might include components such as organizer, WebEx control, the lecture and student. The purpose of this system diagram is to provide a clear and concise representation of system architecture and how it functions, which help to identify potential issues and the area for improvement in the system design. In Figure 4, continue with feasibility test. This slide focus on actual implementation in the real classroom setting high-fec connection. In demonstrate connecting between instructor delivering the class form of campus in the lecture room and the student participant online. Then the student in the classroom could view the lecture video and Lecture material project on the large screen installed in the classroom. First, we have had high fake indication success. The system has been adapted at merging on-site and online platform, allowing for seamless in-person and remote learning simultaneously. Next, we have achieved a consistent learning experience on students wherever online or in the classroom, access the same content, maintaining educational uniformity. However, we did face some audio-visual challenges such as a technical issue between conferencing system and laptop, which were actively working to smooth out. Importantly, we have seen an eliminate of transmission gap, meaning that hybrid model has bridged the divide content delivery to both on-site and online students, overcoming significant logistical hurdle. And finally, this potential for enhanced learning, our findings indicate that with the right tool, hybrid can be a powerful method for creating more adaptable and dynamic learning environment. In conclusion, our comprehensive feasibility test have validated the hybrid lecture format. This innovative approach leaving both on-site and cloud-based system suitable for global universities. The investigation of this system has been effective addressing financial consideration, technological infrastructure, and student engagement equitably. This approach provides an equal learning experience for both remote and in-person students. The challenges inherent to hybrid model, notably using current technology to merge traditional with digital learning, creating more flexible and exclusive educational system for students and faculty. As we look to the future work to investigate the impact of hybrid system on student learning outcome, engagement, and satisfaction of determined to effectiveness in improving student performance and satisfaction with the learning experience.